was named after the great mystic saint of Avila, the foundress of the Reformed Carmel at her baptism. She also received a second name as Heaven's Reward, Mariam, at the age of 27. At the end of 3 years of severe trial by the hell, the Blessed Virgin added her holy name to make it Mariam Theresia. During the 3 years of diabolic trials, Blessed Virgin had stayed close to her, comforting her after midnight every day. Once, the devils complained to God, saying that it was because of the help of Mother Mary, Theresia was unyielding to their temptations. It is written that Blessed Mother did no longer come to her help except for the last 3 days of severe trials. It was at the end of the gruesome trials and trials that Mariam Theresia won against the massive attack of devils. Blessed Virgin Mary spoke to Father Joseph, saying, in thanksgiving to God, she must be called Mariam Theresia. 8 December 1904, on the feast of the Immaculate Conception, she was thrilled when she was first called Mariam Theresia by her spiritual father, Father Joseph Vidyate, who regarded her as a Christ-sent anew by heaven. Blessed Mary had been Theresia's constant recourse and refuge from her childhood. From the age of 3 or 4, she committed herself to her protection and excelled in devotional practices in her honor. She says, I fasted every Saturday in honor of the Blessed Mother and recited the whole rosary until I learned to read. I attended daily Eucharist and did acts of charity in honor of Blessed Mother. Father Vidyate also wrote in his history that Theresia chose Mary for her mother from her infancy. When she was just 3, not knowing how to use the rosary, she held it in her hand while praying. Mother Mary appeared to her, recited the rosary with her, and thus taught her how to recite it. It was Blessed Virgin Mary who asked Father Joseph Vidyate to build a house of solitude for Theresia to pray in 1903. However, when it was reported to the bishop, he refused to grant permission, saying, it is not customary to our times. I do not believe in all these things. If it is from God, I would like to be assured by a sign. Blessed Virgin granted him with a sign altering the termination date of Heaven's trail for Theresia, shortening it from 23rd January 1905 to 8 December 1904, as he had requested. Later, when she was staying in the Carmelite convent at Ullur, Bishop Menajeri called her by her new name, Mariam Theresia. The name was officially given to her, Sister Mariam Theresia, on 14th May 1914, with the institution of the Congregation of Holy Family. On 5th October 1906, Mariam Theresia had a vision after Holy Communion, in which Blessed Mary's heart was given to her. It was placed on the right side of Jesus' heart, received earlier. The symbolic meaning of this vision specified a deep and personal love that united the two hearts into one. Mariam Theresia was very much devoted to Blessed Mother of the Assumption. She used to prepare for this feast in a special way by fasting, penances, and with the recitation of 40 Hail Marys for 25 days. Theresia asked her sisters that God would look after all our needs and taught them an ejaculation, My Mother, My Trust. Mariam Theresia learned the mysteries of heaven from Blessed Mother, and she remained faithful, consecrating her body and soul to her. It is true that all who wants to reach Jesus should go to Mary first. For Theresia, mother and son were not to be separated, they are but one. Every intervention of Blessed Virgin led Theresia to the fulfillment of God's will through her. Virgin Mary prepared her as a perfect bride to Jesus and to the institution of the Congregation of Holy Family through her. Let us have an outlook to the miraculous ways which led to the great plan of God to fulfillment in Theresia. Let us keep in touch prayers.